Thank you so much. Aia. Cafiano dente, loco magna, finas comun. Finas continuo, fac eu, ideia, isco e fnapuia. O asa cuscaia, finas continuo, fac eu. My friends, my relatives, I'm very happy to be here to the elders, the youth, the men, the women, the leadership, the chiefs. A very powerful, powerful event is happening here. The movement across Turtle Island, you can feel that energy. And that's a powerful thing to see in this area. From our federation, we bring greetings. From our Federation of Nations in our territory. From our Cree people, Nihewak, the Swampy Cree, the Woodland Cree, the Plains Cree, we bring greetings. To the Denisote, the Dene, the people of the land, to our Ojibwe people, to Anishina, Avec, to our Dakota, Dakota tribes, our nations, we bring greetings from our FSIN. We also acknowledge the Algonquin people here for opening up their doors for us here. Thank you, TV. We thank them. To our elders for their prayers, we thank them. Last night we had a very, very powerful pipe ceremony last night along with Chief Spence, and that was really a powerful time because that brought together that spirit of our ancestors. We acknowledge the pipe carriers because that is how our treaties were made, nation to nation. That sacred covenant is alive and well. That sacred covenant is what we represent to our traditional tribes. To our people here, we see not only indigenous peoples, but we see our white brothers and sisters as well. We see the Métis people, our brothers and sisters are here. We see the Inuit people, their brothers and sisters are here. All of our 58 nations from across Canada are here. Our youth, our men, the women, the elders. This is a movement because now it is a time for change, transformational change. Our treaties were meant to be peaceful coexistence and mutual respect. We shared this territory. We did not surrender the land and resources. We're sharing. And it was a nation-to-nation relationship that we want respected, honored, and implemented. Now it's time. We're not meant to be poor in our own territories. Our treaties did not meant to make us poor in our own land. And that's what we're going to be changed. Movement is about addressing hope for the future for our young people so that they have that education they need, that education in a good way, proud of their identity as indigenous people. That's what this is about. We are tired of overcrowded houses. We are tired of black folk. We are tired of being filled, our people in the jails. We're going to bring about a change, and we have to do that in unity and in strength as indigenous people. We acknowledge the women that started this movement. We acknowledge and lift up the women because our elders say half our lodges are male, half the lodges are female. Lift them up high because they are true leaders as well. We thank them. And to our colleague and our hero, Chief Spence, we thank you, Chief Spence. Our hearts, our prayers are with you over there on that island. You are asking for fairness, you are asking for justice, you are asking for a meeting again with the Crown to implement and recognize inherent rights, to implement and recognize the spirit and intent of that treaty, because that's hope for the future. And we are praying that that's going to be a reality soon, because we want you to walk with us. We don't want you to carry you from that island. We want you to be strong with us. We want you to be with us when we walk again. And we call on the Prime Minister to set that meeting up. Yeah! We want that meeting. The last message, friends and relatives, it's in unity. She asked for unity, she prayed for unity. This movement has united us from coast to coast to coast. And it is this unity, that strength of working with our youth, getting the elders together, the women together, the youth, the chiefs, the leadership, working together, cooperation, working together collectively. We will bring about transformative change in this land, because now it is time for that change. Now it is time for justice. Now it is time for us to rise up and take our rightful place in this land as indigenous people. Our Assembly of First Nations, our National Chief Atlio, we thank and acknowledge for his leadership. All of our regional chiefs are here. all of us from coast to coast. It's that unity to work together. It's that unity, that's what we need. And today, it's a spiritual awakening. It is a spiritual movement because that's how we say as indigenous peoples, that covenant with the Creator is still there. These treaties cannot be broken. We are people of the land. Lastly, my friends and relatives again, we also have an elder that's fasting and praying in Cross Lake as well, Elder Robinson. And that's important to recognize. All our prayers from our elders go out to him as well for that strength and courage. And my last comment here, because we as indigenous peoples are stewards of the land. That is our right. That is our responsibility to protect Mother Earth. All these bills, no consultation or consent, Bill T-45, it affects the environment, it affects the water, it affects the land. One of our wise elders from Kinigan ZB, Elder William Commanda, and his words were these, on this land, on Mother Earth, the water, the lakes, the rivers and streams, give life to Mother Earth, just like the veins in your body, bring life to all your body parts. Those must be respected, that water gives life to Mother Earth. And we must protect that water. We must protect the land. Keep it clean. Keep it clean. So it can get us with the strength and vitality and energy of our youth. With the strength and vitality and energy of our women, the women. With the strength and vitality and wisdom of our elders. We will be idle no more.